My name is Leon Shannon, and I have muscular dystrophy. Growing up, we go to each other's house, knock each other's door, call each other up, go play some ball. You know, it was nothing. It was free. It was fun. I played a lot of basketball all day. I would play basketball all day to the night. Walk home, take a shower, be tired, wake up next day and do it again.
I would say before 2011, my mother-in-law actually brought it to my attention. And one day Leon was walking and she says, "Why is he walking like that?" And I looked at him because I never saw it. I said, "What do you mean? He's always walked like that." Because I thought, you know, he walked like that in high school too.
We're either, you know, hanging out, maybe playing some video games, or we're at open gym, you know, playing basketball all day, every day. We talk about this one time, and before we knew what was going on with Leon in high school, when during practice, you know, Leon was on the court, and then me and our other friend Delbert were there watching, you know, them play, and then there was one play where a fast break, and, you know, everyone was going down, and for some reason, we saw Leon trying to run, but he just seemed a little slower than others. And he seemed like real heavy. So I remember we looked at each other like, "You see that?"
I am by myself an adult neurologist, so I don't see a lot of children with muscular dystrophies, but we do see them in adults. They mostly present with this muscle weakness. That can affect various parts of the body. Different muscular dystrophies cause different, what we call, pattern of weakness. Some affect the hands, some affect the shoulders, some affect the legs more.
When I got out of high school, I noticed just that I started to get more of a sway, you know. When I was walking, my walk kind of swayed more, and I kind of had like a limp, you know. People would be like, "Yo, what's wrong with you, you know, what's going on?" I'm like, "I don't know what it is, nothing, you know, brush it off, it's nothing really."
And so I thought maybe we just had to work out more, or, you know, because we hadn't been working out. So then we did start to work out together, and he noticed that he felt a lot more tired than usual. And so after that, we started seeing the doctor. We didn't get many clear answers after that. So we saw another doctor and the next one, and eventually he had a biopsy. And that's when the doctor told me that he had diagnosed Leon with muscular dystrophy.
Everything is not like it used to be, of course. So whenever I go to restaurants, sitting inside of a booth, because the chairs are kind of so low, and then when you get out the booth, I need something to help me, you know, lift up and get out. I just can't stand up with my thighs. So like boots, high stools, wherever it is, I like high chairs. So high stools is a go-to thing for me. Gotta have high stools. Flip-flops. Nice good pair of comfy flip-flops to help me through my day, because my feet really takes a lot if I'm standing up or whatever I'm doing, whatever it is, I'm standing up, walking, I gotta make sure I got some flip-flops. With my condition of muscular dystrophy, there's no cure. I like to just do my stretches in the morning. Sometimes when I have time, I do my stretches. I like to eat a lot lighter, healthy drinks. I've been eating something for like energy and a little detoxing drink, a little kale drink, like with apples, bananas, celery, vegetables.
Leon's mindset is so positive. He's just generally an amazing man. It has changed in a way where he, you know, he's not able to play basketball the way he used to, skateboard the way he used to, but he has not let that bring him down. He, if anything, he puts all of his energy into our son.
Teach me how to fly. All my life you've been that angel in disguise. And I hope you learn to make it on your own. And if you love yourself, just know you'll never be alone. I hope that you get everything you want and that you chose. I hope that it's the realest thing that you ever know. Hope you get the pretty girls, it's pretty at everything. $1 million cribs, have $1 million dreams. When you get it all, just remember one thing. Remember one thing, that one man can change the world. One man can change the world.
and grown now to where he understands that, you know, he's not going through this because he's a victim. You know, I think he takes it in as he's going through this, and he has to turn it into something positive and something good to be able to help others or inspire people. And, you know, you hear so many stories about people with conditions that are unfortunate, but yet they do so many good for the world and for other people. And yeah, I feel like Leon Shannon is a perfect example of that.
What other people are going through nowadays, you know, diagnosis with cancer and MS and so many other illnesses that are out there, I think that really puts things into perspective for us, because his mindset is things could always be worse.
If you're living with something and, you know, it's affecting you, you gotta like be aware of people around you too. Like, you can either spread it, you can either spread good, you can spread happiness and joy, or you can spread misery, you can spread bad vibes, negativity, you can spread that too. So if you're going through something, just find something that makes you happy and makes you want to continue to go, you know, like think about your family or just the fact that you're alive, and things can be worse is what I always say. And for that, the only disability in life is bad attitude. And that's something that I heard and I think is real.
All my life you've been that angel in disguise, and I hope you learn to make it on your own. And if you love yourself, just know you'll never be alone. I hope that you get everything you want and that you chose. I hope that it's the realest thing that you ever know. Hope you get the pretty girls that's pretty at everything. $1 million cribs, $7 million dreams. When you get it all, just remember one thing. Remember one thing, that one man can change the world. That one man can change the world.